So early in your career, and yet here you are in this amazing opportunity, right? I mean, pay-per-view, Las Vegas, end of the year. What's the feeling like, the emotion like for you? It's got to be exciting.
It's a dream come true. Just last year, I was actually here for Fight Week as well, but it was for Cody winning the championship belt. So it's crazy because at that time I wasn't in the UFC, but obviously my eyes were always set for this. So it's crazy to be here just a year later, but this time it's my turn, and I'm fighting the former champ. So I'm really, really excited. It's just a dream come true.
It's been such a fast rise for you. I mean, I know every fighter dreams of competing at the highest level and being a champion and all those things, but I mean, in your head, did you believe it could happen this fast?
I always believe from the first time that I started training and fighting, like 7 years ago, I started training. I always knew that I'd be really successful at it. Once I made my professional debut last year, I didn't think I was going to get into the UFC at 3-0, like right away. The opportunity arose. It was there. It presented itself. Sean Shelby sent me a message like 10 days out. Like they're like, "Hey, you want to take this fight? If it's there." And I'm like, "Yes, 100%." You know what I mean? It's like you can't wait for the perfect opportunity when it comes, and you take it and you run with it. And you got to be prepared. And so it's kind of where I was at. I was just getting prepared for a fight. I was staying ready, but I didn't know where I was gonna fight, and I didn't think I was gonna get a UFC shot at 3-0. So when I got it, and I just ran from it. And ever since then, I just been on a roll. But I know I belong here. I know I belong at this level. It's just a matter of putting in, that time and getting those wins.
I was going to say, I mean, the confidence to be able to step into those opportunities. I mean, were there ever moments, or have there been moments along the way where you like look around and go, do I really belong here? Like, I mean, are they going to find out I'm faking it somehow?
Well, I train at the best gym in the world, and I get to train with so many high-level fighters that I get to test myself against like every day in and out. There's nobody out there that I'm gonna fight that I haven't seen at the gym, So all my confidence comes from there, from my preparation, my work ethic and my team, and like there's nothing in there that's gonna scare me where I'm not afraid to like fight my way through. There's no doubt in my mind, I'm not gonna sit here and try to convince people, be like, "Oh, I'm gonna do this." No, I like to tell people, don't believe me, just watch.
Very nice. You've been getting a lot of attention too early in your career, which I got to think is good. I mean, you want to have fans, you want fighters, need those fans to build their way up. But what's it been like for you? As you said, a year ago, not even in the UFC, now all the cameras, the attention. I mean, is it fun? Is it a little nerve-wracking? Do you feel pressure? What's that been like?
It's fun. I'm enjoying the process. That's the big part of it. It's like, ups and lows. I know I've been low and I've been high, so it's very important. Hopefully I don't lose sight of it. A lot of the fighters, after fighting for so long, I feel like they just kind of come numb to it, and they're so used to it. So I want to enjoy it every single time, every fight week. I want to come here and I want to have like a good time with everybody that's here. And it's very important. It's very important for to not only work hard, but to enjoy the journey.
After your last win, you asked for this fight. You threw a couple names out, but this was one of them. Why was a fight with Carla a fight that you thought made sense for you?
Well, at that time, I had just broke. I just beat, sorry, Joanne Calderwood, and I broke top 10. So I got ranked at number 8 at that time. And when they asked me who I wanted to fight next, of course, right above me was number 6 Michelle Waterson, number 7 Carla Esparza. I'm not gonna be disrespectful and be like, "Hey, give me that shot right away to the title." You know what I mean? I'm gonna earn my way up there. I wanna fight these girls, and I wanna prove myself that I belong at the top, and that I deserve that title shot. So why would I not wanna fight the former champ? She's up above me, it's gonna help me. So at that time, it was a right call for me to
nothing
call
personal,
out.
Just yeah, a business decision.
Just a business decision. I have nothing but respect for all these women in the division. Like, I want to fight every single girl in the UFC. There's different challenges, and I just want to prove that I'm the best out of all of them.
Former champion, as you said, she's had some mixed results as of late. What do you break down when you see her and you look at her game? I mean, do you still feel like she's at that championship level? Do you see some flaws? What do you think?
Well, I feel like the game, the MMA game overall is evolving a lot, and like we have so many complete fighters and stuff. I know, traditionally she originally started with wrestlers, so that's just something that's always going to be embedded like in her. So she's really good at that. And it's something that she can always like fall back into. But I know she's been working extremely hard. She wants to get back to being a world champion, and she's right there too, with me. She knows that beating me and stopping me would put her back up there in that title contention. And I know that's where she wants to be, especially her going down lower in the ranks. I'm a good fight for her. She's a good fight for me. And you know, I think her wrestling is a big key, and but she's gonna be hungry. She wants to come back, and I'm ready for it. It excites me to know how hungry she is.
What do you feel like the stakes are for you? Because I think there's a lot of people saying you beat a former champion. Yes, you're not trying to rush up the ranks, but you beat a former champion. You've got this nice streak together. You got a lot of positive attention. Maybe we start talking title shot for you. Are you looking at this as a potential number one contender fight, or one that can get you a number one contender fight?
Yeah, 100%. If it's either this one or another one, or say, you know, a fight falls out and I got to step in, I'm going to be ready. I'm going to be prepared. You know, whatever it is, you know, whether it's going to take me 2, 3, 4, 5 fights until I get that title shot, great. If it's the next one, great. I mean, that's the ultimate goal. I'm not going to stop till I get it. It doesn't matter to me. But I think that it's going to come 2018. I mean, as long as I keep winning, you know, I've said it before, they can't deny me.
You know, it's funny because you haven't been a pro that long, and yet here you are with this great opportunity in front of you. What is it? I mean, is it your work ethic? Is it are you naturally talented? Is it a gift that you have? Is it your attitude? How is it that you've been able to progress this fast?
I think it's a combination of all of it. I feel like I've always just had like the fiery Mexican, like just fight. You know, we don't back down. You know, especially me being from Eastside San Jose. I had my first fight. I think it was like 5th grade or some 4th grade and stuff like that. You know, you don't back down. It don't matter what it is. So it's like, I'm sorry. I kind of got lost a little bit in the questions, just talking about how me getting fights when I was little, man. It was exciting.
Well, you know, that's part of it, though. You know, just kind of what you attribute your fast rise to, you know, if it's something that you just have.
Yeah, my work ethic, my parents, you know, being from a Mexican family, man, we wake up early and we bust our butt and we do a great job doing it. You know what I mean? And that's the one thing that they instilled in me. And also, you know, I do think I'm naturally, like, I picked up on fighting a lot because it's just something inside me, but my work ethic and the team that I have, like, I'm unstoppable. I mean, there's no way that, you know, I can't be successful without, you know, having a good work ethic, good mindset, and a good team, you know, and a good support system around me. Nobody can stop me.
Very nice. Well, every time you fight, it's the biggest fight of your career because they just keep getting bigger and bigger. But how do you see this thing going down on Saturday night?
Hopefully I get that first round finished. I'm really gunning for a TKO. I've been getting on, I've got 2 submissions this year. I got a few TKOs, but those TKOs were due to ground and pound. I want to get a knockout, man. I want to try to knock somebody out standing. So hopefully this Saturday you guys will get that treat, and you know, I'll get that finish in the first round via TKO or KO.